Hi, I'm Bruce Northam. Welcome to American Detour. We're in New Orleans investigating the roots of patriotism.
In 2000, 6 million World War II veterans were alive. In 2010, that number dwindled to less than 2 million. All of them still have strong wills, to say the least.
What does patriotism mean to you?
Well, it means everything.
It means that this is my country, and I would do anything in the world, including giving my life for this country.
Well, I think it's when you put your country ahead of anything else, I think that's patriotism.
It gives me the privilege to tell people that I can go where I want to, when I want to, and be with who I want to be with, and to tell everybody, God bless America.
The World War II Museum's Solomon Victory Theater's spellbinding in-house feature, Beyond All Boundaries, is an immersive 4D cinematic experience and an enlightening geography and history lesson.
At the same time, it's huge in scope, but it's also the personal story of what happened in World War II and why it affects us all today, why it still matters.
Tom Hanks narrates, and dozens of soldiers share testimonials while breaking-edge audio, film, and prop technology, including vibrating seats, bomb fog, and raining confetti, fight the tyranny in Europe and Asia.
I'm proud to have served as executive producer of Beyond All Boundaries, and you can see it exclusively every hour only at the National World War II Museum in New Orleans.
The American Sector, a nearby area was named that at the time of Jefferson's Louisiana Purchase, is the museum's dynamic restaurant overseen by top chef master John Besh.
I have just hold this generation of the people that this museum honors, the greatest generation, in the highest esteem for all that they sacrificed so that I can do what I do today.
Besh, a First World Gulf Marine veteran and frequent contributor to disaster site food relief worldwide, borrowed the American Sector's drink list from an actual 1940s Blue Room. Naughty.
Welcome to the New Orleans Stage Door Canteen!
Committed to bringing the history of World War II to life, the museum's Stage Door Canteen reenacts a hokey 1940s G-rated live show called Let Freedom Swing. This sort of father's knows best entertainment was many soldiers' last hurrah before shipping off to a war that killed 65 million people, forever changing the world. Louisiana's patriotism spills into the streets.
What does patriotism mean to you?
Loving your country and standing up for that.
Another pavement-singing sage believed that patriotism shouldn't have borders.
It's a sphere. There's no over here, there's no over there, it's one surface. And if we're patriotic about Earth, I'm on board.
Performing at the splendid Ogden Museum of Southern Art, John Mooney had another take on nationalism.
Well, I think, you know, the love you have for your country, you know, for the people that, you know, you live with, and, you know, just the whole, you're supporting what you got, you know.
Another New Orleans museum sensation is the NOMA, New Orleans Museum of Art. Established in 1911, there's an entire room dedicated to colorful architectural paintings by William Woodward, a pioneer of the French Quarter's preservation movement. I also roved backstage into the Louisiana State Museum's storage archives for some very emotional moments browsing through retired World War II uniforms.
This is a really nice one. The wings here represent the U.S. Army Air Corps, which is the predecessor to the Air Force. This is worn by a Major Hecker in World War II. It's hard not to be patriotic in an environment like this where we have so many documents, so many artifacts representing the way that Louisianians have participated in battles and wars over the years.
Hopefully, the sort of pride and will still thriving in New Orleans is a renewable resource. I have seen that life persists in the midst of destruction. Therefore, there must be a higher law than that of destruction. Mahatma Gandhi.